the scene of a recent triumph. Only last September, John Bow and Dick Johnson won the Sandown 500. Today, the Ford Falcon drivers continued to rule, blasting over the 3.1-kilometre circuit. Bow clocked 1 minute 12.81 seconds, nearly a second inside his own lap record. Johnson, the next quickest. Glenn Seaton makes up a Ford trifecta. Larry Perkins carries the Holden flag, fourth on the grid. The Commodores have six of the top 10 spots, the troubled Peter Brock filling the last.
The car is not running at all happily. I'm having to sort of lift it by the scruff of the neck and hurl it around the corners.
But less worries for the front runners.
I don't think tomorrow is going to be easy by any means, but it should be a real good hard race for all the people that follow motor racing.
Perfect conditions prevailed at Sandown, enabling John Bow to set a benchmark lap of 1 minute 12.8 seconds, 1 second under his own track record. Seven drivers tied in under the mark, with Bow and Dick Johnson in their Shell FAI Falcon securing the front row for the championship opener.
We finished 94 and a high, and we'd like to continue that way, so starting first is the best way to do it.
Glenn Seaton was only marginally slower, but a couple of braking binds put teammate Alan Jones down the queue behind Larry Perkins and Wayne Gardner, the day's big improver in the Coke Commodore. Hurdling the ripple strips was common practice for most of the top 10 qualifiers, and although it's early days yet, the new EF Falcon appears to have a slight edge over the VR Commodore, with Bow keen to establish a big points break while Mark Scaife sits out the Sandown opener. Mike Raymond reporting for Sports World.
I'm Moffat. Welcome, gentlemen, and I guess, Mike, the first question, what's the weather like?
Bruce, it's Melbourne. It's the middle of summer.
Be careful.
I'm sorry. It was fine yesterday, and everyone expected dry conditions today of about 22. They've got about 17 to 18, and it is bucketing down here.
And, Alan, do you agree that the Falcons at the moment look like they might have an edge on the Commodores from what we've seen early on?
Yes, they do, Bruce. I think it's a compliment to Johnson Racing, where they've been able to expound on their great win at Bathurst last year. They did well in Adelaide and obviously have worked very hard over Christmas to keep that edge, but it's only the first round of the championship. 10 rounds in this, at this level with the degree of competition, Holden will come back. It's only a phase.
And Mike, just finally before we go to the dash for cash, what about the tyre situation, the earthquake in Kobe affecting the supply of tyres? Would that have an effect on today's race?
I don't think so much today, Alan, but I think it will impact quite severely for all those Dunlop runners over the next couple.
Well, I think the thing that has to be noted with reference to Dunlop, Bruce, is that they supply the majority of the rest of the field, not just the top teams, and it might be tight on some of those privateers that are already struggling.
Well, Mike, I know that Bow and Johnson particularly as a team had a great day yesterday, and they're well placed as we're about to have the draw, I think, for the Dash for Cash.
Yes, Bruce. This year, of course, they have opened the field up. Last year we had the top six. Today we've had the top 10, so it's been expanded. Same number of laps here at Sandown. The draw, Johnson was looking for two or a three, didn't get it. And can you believe, with Mark Scaife out this weekend, look who has pulled it. His teammate carrying Scaife's number today, Jimmy Richards, car number two. Here's the lineup. Jimmy Richards in car number two will start on the front row. Alongside him will be Thomas Mazera in the mobile Commodore. Then out of row number two, and a wet weather runner, if ever I've seen one, Larry Perkins in the Castrol Commodore. Position four is Alan Jones in the Peter Jackson Falcon V8. Then we look at row number three, Dick Johnson and John Bowd. What would be the chances of the two of them pulling side by side out of the third row? Fourth row inside will be Neil Crompton in the Coca-Cola Commodore. And then on the outside of him, Glenn Seaton, the Peter Jackson Falcon. And, of course, the last row, Wayne Gardner in the Coke Commodore and Peter Brock in the mobile Commodore VR. So that's a pretty good-looking lineup. This morning, of course, with the rain coming down, we've had a couple of cars go off in the morning warm-up, which has set things back here. But Andy Raymond has got a very special guest. We're all looking forward to Mark Scaife joining us here today to go racing. But after that terrible shunt at Eastern Creek a few weeks ago, Mark Scaife has elected not to run today, and I think quite wisely, because he's still black and blue.
Well, if he's not happy with his own fitness, he's the one that has to make that choice, but it hurts his championship points. But being the champion in his, I know he'll come back with a vengeance.
We always try to find a good job for Andy. Today it's out in the rain. Down to him.
Yeah, thanks, Mike. A miserable day here at Sandown, and the weather was pretty much like this on January 19. It was practice for the Eastern Creek Triple Challenge, and my guest at this moment, Mark Scaife, this weather would bring back bad memories.
Yeah, well, I think I made the right decision today, mate, didn't I? But, you know, I feel sorry for John Davison, to be honest. It was a great day yesterday, and he's done a great job with the promotion and the circuit. And for it to rain so early on Sunday morning is bad news.
Mark, the question everyone's asking is how you're feeling at the moment.
You know, I feel okay. I'm still a little bit sore, obviously. I've got some rib cartilage damage, but I did a few laps in the car at Calder the other day, and yeah, it was pretty painful.
Yeah, one of these V8 touring cars certainly throws you around. That'd be the last thing you'd need. Tell me, you've been to physio and you go to another radiologist later this week.
Yeah, that's the go at the moment. I've just got to have a few more things done to sort of see what sort of recuperation things that we can do in terms of trying to sort of hurry some things along. And probably in terms of the forces in the car and the bumps, you know, that's what we've got to try to compensate for.
Mark, when can we expect to see you back in the Winfield car?
Hopefully for Simmons Plains and Tassie, so that should be great.
And today's race in the wet weather, is that going to suit your teammate Jim Richards?
No, well, you know, I think Richard will take a fair bit of beating, but, you know, there's a lot of guys that are going to go very, very well, and the cars are very, very close, so it should be a great race.
Mark, I know you're not much of a spectator, but enjoy your day.
Thanks, mate.
He's a wonderful young guy, Mark Scove. Sorry to see him out of the opening round of the championship. As I said, the morning warm-up, well, John Bauer is on pole, but at the moment he's in a sand trap. And that's held up proceedings here at Sandown International Raceway. Huge crowd flocking in here for the opening round of the Shell Touring Car Nationals. And we'll have that for you, Bruce, a little later in the show. We'll come back with the...